Well, good morning, everybody. Welcome back to another film. I've just arrived on location. Another one of those miserable grey days, I'm afraid. But spring is about to pop, and I'm looking forward to getting out to see what Mother Nature has provided for me this week. I'm just getting my gear to ready because I've literally just chucked everything in the bag as I came out of the house, and I'm not going to need those just yet. Waterproof socks. So I'm not quite ready to go. I'm just going to finish my coffee, which I got from Starbucks on the way here, which I stupidly decided to get caffeine instead of decaf. I've been going for the last 3 or 4 weeks on decaf coffee, and I've been feeling much better for it. And in my eagerness to get here this morning, I forgot to ask for decaf, so I'm going to be pretty wired on this video today. But I'll get the kit together and get out there. Weather-wise, we've got wind, we've got intermittent rain, and very, very dull overcast conditions. You can probably see the window there if I just move that round. Quick view outside. I mean, it's not raining at the moment, so that's a good thing. I can only be happy about that. But get the kit on and get out. The sooner I get out there, the sooner I can find stuff, and hopefully I can get the video completed today without getting absolutely soaked. But I have got leggings. I've got them with me today. Somewhere they must be in the back, so I'm going to put them on because I think doing the sort of shots that I want to do today, I want to be able to kneel down, and it's probably going to be damp where I'm going. So leggings, order of the day. I'm not going for a waterproof jacket, but I have got the trusty brolly. That's important. Lunch is ready for when I get back, so let's get out there and see what I can find. See you shortly. No, I don't want to get too carried away and go straight into the wood. I'm going to spend a little bit of time just looking at this woodland edge, because it's all too easy to get fixated on getting in and looking what's inside the wood. But as I've mentioned before, you get these transitional zones which can often yield some great things. And I'm not saying I'm going to find anything great, but it's worth just spending that little bit of time just looking along the edge, because it's very, very different at the edge than it actually is in the woodland itself. So 10 minutes here is not wasted. So I've not really found anything along the woodland edge, but I was really interested in this old sycamore tree just on the left of the path there. You can see that it's sort of in a pretty poor state, but from a wildlife perspective, it's really providing for the local wildlife community. Just to the top, just out of shot, there's a limb off to the right-hand side. It's absolutely full of feeding evidence of woodpeckers, where they've been drilling in looking for all the internal grubs. But what was really interesting to me, off to the left-hand side, there's a limb that's come down and it's still connected to the tree. And all the buds are still coming out. And all the, what were upper aerial branches, are full of lichens. And the green buds, as they were just bursting out, in contrast to the silvery lichens in the background, really caught my eye. But I tried for about 10 minutes to try and get a composition, but in the end, the background twigs that you couldn't avoid, you couldn't even, with a small aperture, you couldn't really make anything coherent with it compositionally. So I've left it alone, and I'm going to have a look now into the woods and see what else I can find. do you know what? I'm going to get known as being the leaf guy, aren't I? I can't resist it. They just really jump out at me. I've no idea what this tree is, and it doesn't really matter, but just on top here, there's a lime leaf, a small leaf lime leaf, and a beech leaf, and they've fused to the top of the inner part of the wood on this trunk here. And there's a few of them scattered around, and they're just irresistible, absolutely irresistible. I'm gonna have to take a photograph of that. But as I was coming around the pathway, I mean, I've literally walked down this path. There's the big old sycamore on the left-hand side. The van's only 200 yards away, but I'll just show you this as well that I've just seen. Feather there, just in amongst the leaf litter, and it's got water droplets all over it. And I'm wondering whether I can make a composition of that as well, just on an angle. It might be a little bit too long, I don't know. I'll have a look at it when I've done the leaf. But what a great start to the morning. Right, after much tripod wrestling, I've finally got the camera into position. It was a little bit difficult because you've got two leaves that are going in slightly awkward directions, so it was very, very critical to get them aligned just right, and it's not easy trying to get the tripod legs in the right place just at the right distance. But I've managed it. I've taken a sequence of shots. It's a focus stack, and I'll just show you on the back of here now. So here is the composition that I've just taken. I'm probably gonna have to be quick because I think there's a hail shower on its way. Just brighten that up so you can see it there. Now, as you can obviously tell, the beech leaf on the right-hand side at correct exposure is considerably brighter than the lime leaf on the left. But it's well within the dynamic range of the camera. As you can see with the histogram there, there's plenty adjustment left in, but I certainly don't want to take it at that point there. So I'm just going to edge towards the left and just expose for the highlights, which is the leaf there. Now, it is a focus stack because it's quite a lot of depth to this image. This point here on the left, let me just see my finger, is considerably higher than the section on the right-hand side down here. So it's a focus stack of about 6 images. Now, like I said, the composition isn't quite right, and not the tripod, so I'll just quickly show you that. That's the composition that I arrived at. And yeah, really quite happy with that. But in terms of settings, as you can see, 100 ISO, f/16 and a fifth of a second. So I'll put that on now. So I've just taken a quick shot of the feather. It's actually blown into a different position. I'm not convinced it's better for it. There was a nice oak leaf where it originally was, and it's moved away. I can't even see the oak leaf now. Maybe that's got covered up with the wind. But I've got a nice little diagonal with the feather going through the frame. The water droplets are still on it. Not sure whether the background is a little bit cluttered. Now, you can move these into better positions, but I'm not really that good at doing that. The minute I put something to where I think it's better, whenever I see the image later on the computer, it always feels manufactured, which is exactly what it is. And I would much rather shoot nature as I find it. But like I say, some people are far better at it than I am. I just go with what I get, and I'm happy with that. In terms of settings, it's the same as before, actually, f/16. I'm far enough away in this instance to not need to focus stack. Everything looks nice and sharp throughout the image. So I'm going to put that on now, a nice little infill shot that I wasn't expecting. Yeah, so I'll put that on now. Thank you. it's definitely worth coming back to old locations. This spot here is a place I've visited numerous times over many, many years. And this little patch here is the wild garlic just starting to come up. You've just got the leaves, of course, the flowers haven't come up yet. Within them, there's patches of wood anemones, but because it's a bit chilly this morning, they've all got their heads closed up. I was hoping I might be able to photograph them today, but a couple of years ago, I got a lovely shot of the wood anemones just here, and I'll pop that on screen now quickly. But I thought I'd revisit it and see if there's anything new catches my eye, and sure enough, what I was least expecting is something just where the video camera's positioned there. Couldn't find anything here. I'm loath to wandering amongst it because it's such a shame to stand on this stuff, although when you do stand on it, it smells amazing. The garlic really comes through, but nothing as far as I can see from the edge here, so I'm going to shoot just what I've found down here now as an alternative, but it's no weaker for it, I have to say. Right, so just down here is a lovely patch of opposite-leaved golden saxifrage, a lovely little woodland plant. All the yellow that you can see is exactly that. And just down here, there's a frond of cow parsley. Now, there are some evidence of Himalayan balsam, which is this horrible stuff that's just here coming up all around. And within a few weeks, this whole scene will have gone, and I wouldn't be able to shoot it. So I've been lucky enough to get to it today, because the balsam that's down at the bottom at the moment is just going to come right up and just shade all this out. So I'll get the camera out and take this image. What I've got is literally the frond of the fern, and it's just sat beautifully amongst the sea of yellow saxifrage behind it. There is this twig here of a sycamore just coming through, but I've had the fawn up and just aligned it, and it's certainly not in the way. And to be honest, what I might just do is put a rock from the stream bed there and just flatten it down and leave it. Sycamore is a weed, technically. But I'm not one for pulling them out. To me, it's one of our native trees these days, and I'm more than happy to see it in the countryside, albeit it's not the most diverse species that we currently have. But yeah, I'll just flatten it down for now, and then it's out of the way of my composition. So here is my shot, all lined up. You can see that I've got the frond on a lovely diagonal, moving through the frame from left to right, and that gorgeous opposite leaf golden saxifrage really creates a beautiful frame for the background. The problem I've got is, as you can see, the quiver is just something that I'm going to have to deal with. I'm going to have to be prepared to stand here for quite some time, probably until that thing stops and I can just grab a quick shot. But I've taken a couple already, but every one of them is a little bit soft around the edges of the leaves there, so a bit of a waiting game, but I'm prepared to do it because I think that is well worth the effort. I've been stood here for 15 minutes trying to get a shot of this leaf, this fern frond, cow parsley frond, whatever you want to call it, and there's a constant breeze, and it very, very rarely drops long enough for me to take a shot, and I've taken must be 20, and every one of them is soft so far. I have upped the ISO to 800. I don't really want to go to 1600, but I want to retain that f16. I certainly can't focus stack this because I can't guarantee that the frond is going to rest back in the same place every time, so I'm having to just edge my bets and take a shot and review it each time, and eventually I'll get what I want. I'm pretty sure of that. Another one there. But I will get it, and when I do, I can move on. And I'm that confident, I'm going to put the shot on now. I found a stick, and I think it's a stick that her dog's just discarded. Shall I photograph it? I'll show it you. There's the stick. But I'm thinking, going in a little bit closer. Can you see that forming there? Lovely S shape. Or maybe a more of a vertical. Bearing in mind that my camera's got more of a square crop compared to this. But I'm thinking that's got some potential. Just look at those, look at the patterning on the stick, how it really works nicely with the leaf litter. Let's give it a go. I think we've got something here. I really like that. I've spent quite a lot of time inching the tripod around, just getting the position exactly right, because I felt that was really crucial to the success of the image. I'll get you on the back of the tripod now and let you have a look. So here is the final frame. I suppose the one question I have is the branch a little bit too heavy duty, let's say, for the shot overall. Still love that patterning though. There's definitely something about it I really like. It's one of those that I think is only going to really be appreciated once I see it on a big screen, and then I probably would know for sure if it's going to work or not. Annoyingly, the sun's coming in and out at the moment. Just darken that down a little bit. It's coming out, so going back in again now. Right, so there. Now, what I think is most important with this, you're viewing it as a landscape at the moment. I'm probably going to flip this as a vertical when I show the final frame. And I've got a little pointer here. So you can see that the stick enters the frame there at the corner and leaves the frame at the bottom corner. So you've got a beautiful diagonal. Now, what I was very careful to do and why I think this works more on the vertical is that the little knot, I don't want to draw too much attention to that because it's not one of the most beautiful things within the frame, let's say, but I have placed it just on the third line, just so it helps the frame just hang together really quite nicely. And the colours are so well, they work so well with those leaves surrounding them. What I might do is, like I think I said before, the browns, I might just tone them down so it's got more of a monochromatic feel, and perhaps a little vignette around the edges just to soften the part where the branch comes in and out of the frame. But overall, I think it's quite a nice shot. Everything I've taken today seems to be on f16. This is a nice and easy one because it's not moving. I have taken the shot already, and just as a backup, I took one shot with the focus on the middle of the branch there, and I have taken a shot just for the leaves in the background. So hopefully that works out, and we all agree that it's quite a nice shot, and I'll put the image on now. Thank you all so much for watching today's video. Images to come in just a second. If you've enjoyed the video, don't forget to press the like button, and if you want to see more, you can always subscribe to the channel. It costs nothing to do that. Leave some comments, let me know what you think of today's images, and if you want to support the channel more, you can always become a member. You can do that by joining YouTube or Patreon for as little as 99 pence per month. So until next time, I will see you in the next one. Bye for now.